Hey everybody, Kaiser here. Thanks again for coming back to another Lamnesia Let's Play. I just wanted to say it's been a while since I actually sat down to film one of these, as I have been, or I had been, filming these in little batches because I didn't really intend on doing Let's Plays rather frequently, so I figured I might as well make them, then I can edit them at my own leisure. That ended up backfiring since I ended up not being able to use face cam for almost all of my videos up until number 5. And number 5 actually had me with longer hair, and yet I started uploading FaceTime stuff with short hair. So it's kind of a bit of a jump, and I apologize for that. I don't remember any of these keys. This is gonna kick my ass. Oh well, let's get back into it and scare the bejesus out of myself. Yes. Okay, close the door, good. If I remember correctly, I was looking for a key. Nope. Get out of the way. Nope. Can I move the I can't move the shirt.
There it is. I guess it is a good place to hide it then.
I do not trust that door. Give me the key. Give me the key. Machine room key. Oh god. I don't want to do this. Okay, back to the front hall. He panted heavily, trying his best to keep himself from screaming. The medicine cabinet had been overturned and lay collapsed on the floor. He reached for the broken glass and grabbed all the sedatives he could find. Getting a lot of the spinny wheel of death things. That was taking forever to load. Okay, so let's crouch. Let's run. Why did I come in here? What was the point of this room? Okay, because there's always been a point for every room that I've come into. Oh, that would be why. Letter regarding the discovery of an orb. To my most trusted student and friend, Johann Weir, the most remarkable thing happened as I was traveling through the Prussian woods this summer. I finally found one of the orbs I've been looking for the last 20-odd years. It is inexplicable as the heliodromus described it in the Hortus Conclusus. It was as it was told about, an underground Mithraic temple crowned with the unearthly artifact. The orb was big enough to fill my cupped hands, and the texture was smooth and jagged. Its color washed while rich. Contrast is not enough to describe its nature. It was an impossibility, an artificial paradox captured within stone. I was staying in a nearby village called Altstad, investigating one of the antiquated trails, when I finally found the cavern. I went inside, and suddenly I could verify the truth of these enigmatic artifacts. They were real. There's a reason I'm doing this. I don't talk much, so my speaking skills are like... Okay. As you can understand, this is the most important discovery of my life, but it has also become my greatest fear. As I entered the underground chamber, I could feel that I was trespassing. Because of my curiosity, I did my best to fight these instincts and fetch the orb from its place. I scrambled out of the chamber and into the woods. I could sense something was following me. It bayed loudly as it closed in. The beast, this guardian of the orb, was relentless in its pursuit. I made my way to a nearby ravine where I stumbled upon some men fishing in the lake. I tried to warn them as I passed, but fortunately they remained as I continued my escape. When I heard their cry of pain echo through the valley, I felt such a tremendous sense of relief, thinking I would be spared. Oh, that's lovely. I'm just going to be happy that these people are being slaughtered in my place. Suddenly, a blue shimmering light engulfed me, and the colors of the forest were washed away before my eyes. I kept running through the bleak surroundings. The trees had turned charcoal black with leaves of cinder, the ground covered in murky water. I pressed on through the drenched land as the glowing ember gave way to rising wind and rained on me. I could hear pleading screams in the distance, and I joined in as pain and fear overtook me. I fell to the ground, gasping for air. This certainly must sound strange, but I had been carried miles away across the Alps to a grassy field outside Genoa. The guardian had taken the orb from me, but still until this day, I fear its return. Sometimes I lay awake at night, listening for the howling cry I heard in the forest. It has been nearly a decade since that day, and I still haven't been able to write about the incident. The last time we spoke, you told me about your interest and ongoing research into the mythic orbs, and I realized I owed you the truth about my visit to Altstad. Your friend and mentor, Heinrich Cornelius Agrippa. Okay, so someone survived this, so maybe I can get out of here alive. There's hope, potentially. Yellow door. Close. Ooh, Tinder. Okay, other than Tinder, is this the only point of this room? I can open this. No, I can move that, never mind. Another Tinder. Okay. God. This looks horrifying. Oh. Oh dear God, I don't know if I want to read this. Animal experiment. Canis lupus familiaris, 1658, April 12th. After a short study, and it is clear that the agitation found among humans could be found in the dog. Fear and pain induce stress, which seems to trigger an endogenous response, causing the animal to burst with energy. I believe that the catalyst is produced in the brain. It is difficult to determine exactly where and what it is, but I can sense it. It reeks of cosmic genesis. There is an inherent problem in harvesting this energy, since the creature is bound to die from the exercise. I must refine this process of torture to enable any real work to be done. More experiments must be performed, but it seems that only human beings are able to produce the amount necessary. Oh my God. It might be their ability to appreciate the severity of the process that ultimately augments their experience of terror. The fuck? Seriously, Daniel, what did you get into? Like, that's far, like, as far as I can tell, it's...
Let's see what you have to offer.
No.
Ah, what a mess. I should have sharpened the saw. But I can sense it. It's definitely there.
Alexander, you piece of shit. I am going to enjoy killing you. You piece of shit. Oh. In case you hadn't figured it out, I can't stand animal torture, and that is just... I'm gonna kill him. I'm gonna kill him and I'm gonna enjoy it. Oh, it's a bird. Ugh. Oh, is that why I keep hearing dogs and stuff? You are scum. Anatomy Frontiers, 1658, January 9th. Further disappointment. The antiquarian's latest findings yield nothing. I'm still unable to grasp the inner workings of life and its relation to the power I sense within it. I shall pursue more books on the subject, but I suspect it will be in vain. Since no research has been made in my particular interest, I must attempt to fill that void myself. Clearly humans emanate more of the energy I seek, but I hope animals will suffice, as they would provide less of a hassle to acquire. Oh, you son of a bitch. Okay. Clearly you didn't stick to animals. Oh. Gimme. Apparently, tread carefully. Aye, aye. Whew. Okay. What the hell is out there? Do I want to know? Not really. Hi, Mr. Chair. Want to protect me? Okay, elevator machine instructions. If the elevator breaks down again, make sure to use the steam engine to build up pressure before channeling it into the machinery. Adjust the levers to get the right amount of pressure inside the chamber. The meter should read up 8, down 8. Make sure the flow is set according to the following charts. Trinity steam set functions, 4-phase amplitude, and complete steam flow cycle. Note that the machine will not check proper configuration until all the rods are inserted. Oh. Since it's been a while since I've actually played this game, I'm gonna say that I'm gonna make this one a little bit of a shorter one, sort of to kind of ease myself back into the pure terror of this game. Yes, I know not a lot happened, just some spooky stuff, a tree falling over and a window cracking on its own, and that horrifying realization that Alexander's an animal torturer, but I'm going to probably film another episode of this right after this, but I'm going to call this one a day, since it's been about 17 minutes. I usually run closer to 30, but I'm trying to test out a little bit of my video length, see what people like more, and so I'm going to call that a day, and I'll see you guys next time.